In the last class, last 10-15 minutes, we have derived one equation for interface, intraphase together, right? Yeah. And in the graph I have drawn, I have mentioned that that is eta phi square. That must be eta 0 phi square. In the graph x axis, Swami did not draw the graph at all. Did you draw the graph? X axis? X axis is eta phi square I have written there. That must be eta 0 phi square, right? So, I think again I will quickly derive, this also can be derived in another way in terms of eta 0 starting. Yeah, starting with eta 0, this is again interface effectiveness continued. Okay, what we have done in the last class, last minute, you know, last 10-15 minutes we have done that. So, in the hurry we have done, but I think you know all the equations are right, but only thing, one step I have to prove that why that ROB L square by DECB equal to eta 0 phi square, where eta 0 is overall effectiveness factor. Okay? We have used eta bar for external, eta for internal interface, and overall is eta 0. Okay? So, that is what to just yeah, the first definition we had eta 0 equal to R O B by R B. This equation did I write last time? Huh? No, not. Okay, yeah, good. So, this is the one which is missing. So, eta 0 is defined in the normal fashion, that, but this is overall from film to center of the particle. So, the entire dimension is taken for defining this. So, then you have the equation already in terms of C s by C b, I do not know, C s by C b, you have an equation already, please tell me that. K g a divided by K g a plus eta k. Okay? Now, substitute this equation, what was this number? This one is 2, and this one was what was the last number? We will just continue. 7. This we will put as 8. Okay? Good. So, from this, from 8, we can write R O B equal to eta 0 R B, which is, if you take for example, first order reaction and third reaction also, it will be same, no problem. Eta 0 K C B for first order reaction. Correct, no? This is R B. R B is rate based on, yeah, but isothermal only we are talking, please remember that. Okay? This overall interface, that is interface plus interface together, we have been talking only overall, only isothermal condition. So, that is why, so this is no temperature there, it is only K into C B. Now, substitute substitute now for this C s, this is eta 0 K C B one more equation, I think what you have there, So, that is where I have been searching that. Yeah. ROB equal to ROB equal to what is that you have given written there? Not that, the beginning. ROB equal to KGA, yeah. CB is also equal to eta KCS. Eta KCS. So, ROB is also eta KCS. Good. Substitute now, what is this equation number? 1, no? The first one, okay. You do not have to write that equation number. Substitute equation 2 here and tell me what is eta, what is ROB? So, if you are not able to follow still. Yeah. This equation you have, this equation you have, what is that you have here? CS, right? Yeah. Yeah, like Savita, many people also may not understand. This CS, CS substitute here and then what do you get for ROB? Yeah, ROB equal to this whole thing, right? Eta k, eta k, where is this? Yeah, for CS, I have to write CB KG A CB divided by this one KG A. Plus eta k. So, this is the one now. So, substitute this in eta 0. Yeah, you do that later, but I think substitute, what is eta 0? Eta 0 equal to ROB by RB, or in this equation also, this is equation 3. No, not 3, 9. Karthik, what was this equation number? This is already there, that is what I am saying. 3, yeah, this is 3. We are mixing that and this now. So, now substitute for eta 0 and then give me the equation, what do you get? That is equation 8. Substitute equation 3 in 8 with RB also. RB also, you know, RB is KCB. Substitute for RB and ROB. What do you get? One by eta plus. Plus 1 you will get, yeah. 1 by, everyone is giving his own, so I will give my own. So, this is eta KGA. KGA plus eta k, excellent, that is one thing. Now divide, this is also, not 1 by, just to make some 1 plus eta k by KGA. No, there must be some meaning, you know, in writing that. What is k by KGA? Yesterday we have done something else. It will become phi square. Yes, that becomes phi square by Biot number. So eta 0 equal to eta by 1 plus eta phi square by Biot number mass. Okay, good. So, now here you can substitute for tan h. tan h phi by phi for slab, or otherwise for other one spherical particle you have 1 by 3 by phi into whole, that you have to remember, examination is coming in the next week. Okay. Yeah. So, that also you can substitute for any shape, now you can substitute because we have not taken any shape when you are developing this equation. So, only thing that is left to know what should be proved was that R O B C B D E by D E R O B L square, right, R O B L square by, yeah, that is equal to eta 0 phi square, I said. Can you prove that? Eta 0 phi square. What do you start with? This is the equation to start with.
Yes,
sir. So, we got it. Yeah, sir. In equation 9 you can substitute and then get. Equation 9 you have ROB multiply by L square divided by Karthik, searching.
No, sir. Actually, I have taken this equation and substituted in phi squared by phi squared bi plus 1 by eta equal to ROB L squared by d.
So, what do you get?
So, we get eta naught is 1 by phi squared by bi plus 1 by eta.
All that is
so
over.
Eta naught phi square is ROB L squared by d ECB.
Automatically coming there?
Yes, sir. From this equation
6 we got yesterday.
Ah.
Just we rearrange that equation. Then it will give us eta naught expression into pi.
Yeah. So that is one way. And here also you can use the equation, this equation divide by L square, multiply by L square divide by d e, and what is else, the other one? C b, both sides, anyway, C b also will get cancelled. You will also get eta 0 pi square. Okay. So, anyway, let me do that. So, from equation 9, we have R O B L square D E C B equal to this, if I take eta 0 k C B L square, same thing, D E C B, C B C B will get cancelled. This k L square d e is nothing but phi square. So, that will be eta 0 phi square. Yeah, because there are mistakes even in Carberry. Sometimes he writes this one as eta, sometimes he writes mistakes as eta 0. Eta 0 is the correct one for overall. So, in that graph you should have eta naught, okay, eta naught. And please think carefully about that graph. That is, in a graph is looking good, but I think it is not that easy to generate. I may ask you, how do you generate that graph? You know, you have eta 0 versus, the plot was eta 0 versus eta 0 phi square for various biot numbers, for various biot numbers. How do you really generate that graph? Make a question mark there, you know, how do you generate that graph? I want you to think. Good? Yeah, I think somewhere numbers have gone now, 9. So, this was not there, right? It was not there yesterday. So, this is 10, this is 11, this is 12, yeah, okay. Because I realized that, you know, you also should have eta 0 and eta related. That is the reason why I wanted to do that. Otherwise, yesterday it was not obvious. Eta 0 I have not mentioned. So, that is the reason why I thought again I will do it. Okay. So, now next one, what is left to us is, taking all the equations what we have done till now, that means interface effectiveness factor, the temperature profiles, concentration profiles, you know, the particularly temperature difference, concentration difference, and also intraphase temperature difference, concentration difference, you have the relations, right. Can you get some more information from this? Like, for example, I told you thumb rule is for many of the processes in the catalytic reactions, the controlling factor is mass transfer through the pores and heat transfer through the film. Okay. These are the thumb rules, but how do you know that what I am saying is right? You simply believe me, so you say yes. You have to believe me because you think that, you know, if you do not believe, if you write wrong things in examination, then I will not give marks. I think at least for that reason you have to believe. But we have to prove that. We can also prove that. Without trying to use any new equation, all the equations already with you. Till now, in your notes, whatever equations what you have. So that's why what we do now is, this is interplay of intraphase, inter and intraphase resistances. See, now resistances we are talking. Either mass transfer resistance, when do you get, or heat transfer resistance, when do you get. So, that is the kind of information. So, please take this as an introduction. We have seen till now that the general problem of diffusion reaction is quite involved. So, that means, you know, too much information we have generated, it is quite involved in the derivations and all that. Fortunately, however, the physical and chemical processes at work under realistic conditions favor isothermal pellets and negligible external mass transfer resistances. Let us now prove the same. Renita, what did you understand from this para? What did you understand? I think I gave already the answer, very nice answer. Read the second sentence, what you have written.
External mass transfer is neglected and it is considered isothermal inside, so we can solve the problem easily.
Yeah, why should we assume you have isothermal particle? Thumb rules are there nicely. See, I mean, here safely after doing all this, if you are interested in reaction engineering and if you are interested in catalytic reactions in future life, unfortunately, if you get a job somewhere in chemical industry, then you can happily tell this thumb rule. You know, when you have a catalyst particle, you can always assume that the particle is isothermal because heat transfer is not controlling. Or the other way to tell is, mass transfer control is more important in the particle pores. Whereas, if you take the external film, it is the heat transfer which is important, but mass transfer is not a problem. You will have sufficient amount of mass that is going through the film, through the film to reach the surface. Then afterwards is the diffusion. Mathematically also we can prove that with the equations what you have already used. One equation what you have already used is this. That is Ts for external, that means external film, what you have the equation is Ts minus Tb by Tb, if you have notes you can check, equal to beta bar eta bar dA, which we call now as eta bar Ca, where Ca is Carberry number. Some people use this, that is the spelling of Carberry, car plus berry. So this is one equation what you have. Similarly, you have for external. In fact, eta bar dA is nothing but again eta bar dA in terms of concentrations.
1 minus
Cs by Cb. That is also there. Good. So, then the next one is, we have internal, that means intraphase. You have Tc minus Ts, Tc is the center. Equal to this, I think I have to just write. Maybe I think I can also write this, Tb equal to this is beta Cs minus Cc by Cb Cb where beta equal to You have the equation? Minus delta H, minus delta H R d E C B by K E T B. Similarly, beta bar also you have. Okay. So now this is another equation beta. This equation number is 2. So we have also seen that this we will get T C minus T S max by T B equal to eta. Where is eta? Beta into beta into C S by C B. Okay. So, this is equation number 3, equation number 3. So, then why? C S minus C C M, because now earlier you assumed C S equal to C B, but now it is not, Kavya. We are now breaking the problem till T C, I mean T B T S and T S to T C. Similarly, concentration is C B C S C C, and C C is 0 for the maximum temperature difference. Okay? So, that is why this C S will be there. This C S by C B is also nothing but 1 minus eta bar d A, that also we have, this C S is. So, you have same thing I am writing here, T S by T B equal to delta T. Here I have to also write, here this one is just nothing but delta T I max I will write. Okay, delta T I max I, that means internal temperature by T B. So, so this also I am writing as max by T B equal to beta to 1 minus Carberry number. So, this is 4. Okay. Actually, that is eta bar d A. Okay. So, which is as I think here also shall I write Carberry number equal to eta bar d A, otherwise you will get confused later what is this. Good. So, now we will add these two equations, that is 4 and then 1, 4 and 1. So, when you add that, you will have T S minus T B by T B plus T C minus T S by T B equal to beta bar C A plus beta 1 minus C A. This is equation number, let me simplify that some more. So, this becomes T C minus T B by T B equal to beta bar C A plus beta 1 minus C A. So, this is equation number 5. Okay. Now, there is another thing here. This one also please add here, this one has delta T x by T B. I do not want to write another equation there itself, in the first place itself you can write x means external, Yeah. Good. And this one can be written as, this is delta T naught max T c minus T b by T b. That is overall, no? T c to T b. That is why T 0 is overall. M refers max. Okay. So now, if I take the ratio of 5 and 1 as delta T x by delta T naught max, equal to beta bar C a divided by beta bar C a plus beta 1 minus C a, which also can be written as beta bar by beta into C a by beta bar by beta C a plus 1 minus C a. Yeah. So, one more step here, that is delta T x by delta T max equal to, we will write another number B r into Carberry number by 1 minus C a Carberry number plus B r C a. So, this is equation number 6. Where B r is? Anyone heard? B r is what number? Brinkman number. B-R-A-N-K. Brinkman number. How do you know all these numbers? This is what is the problem. No? Most of the time, how do you know means you don't know how to do it.
Transport
phenomenon. Good. Okay, good. Yeah. The BR is Brinkman number. Brinkman number. Yeah. This Brinkman number can be beautifully proved. I just leave it to you. All the information with you. All the equations are with you. Okay. Brinkman number, using all these things, you have mass Biot number by heat Biot number, which is nothing but here beta bar by, yeah. You have all that. You know what is beta bar. All the things are there with you. Definition of beta bar, you know. Definition of beta, you know. Okay. Using those two quantities, you try to get this ratio as BIM and BIH. And you know what is BIM. Okay. BIM is, just I am giving for easy thing, this is K L by D E and kg, and the other number, heat HL by K. So, you have to arrange this beta bar by B, beta bar by beta in this format, then you will get Biot number. Okay, good. So, now I think it is nice, you prove that it is very nice, because I think you have to use again relationships from external the treatment for external effectiveness factor and then do it. Yeah. Which ratio is BR? Oh, sorry. Yeah, correct. See, Abhinav reminded you. Abhinav is today controlling. mass transfer control. Okay, thank you. Okay, good. This is the equations 6, maybe this is 7, this is only definition. Brinkmann number, this is these two definitions. So, anyway, so now what do we do? After deriving the equation, we have to plot, that is our life all the time. After plotting, you have to try to find out what is happening in that plot. Sometimes research also is boring. All the time you find something, plot the graph and explain the graph and publish. Okay. So, that is why unless you have some kicks in any problem, I told you, no, simply increasing, simply decreasing will not give you any thrill. Okay. So, now this is delta x by delta t I, so delta t o max. What is the other parameter I have to plot here? That is that equation 6. What is the other parameter? CA. CA is nothing but eta bar dA. Okay. CA is nothing but eta bar dA, and eta bar dA also you know, which you can measure and all that. But anyway, that is not required here. This is CA, and you have this side 0 to 1. Eta bar dA cannot be more than 1. I do not know whether you have checked, no, earlier. Eta bar dA. All the plots are between 0 and 1. Now go back. At least you will go back next week anyway. You have the exam. Okay. So this is 0 to 1, though maybe 0.2, 0.4, 0.6. No, no, 0.8 is there. 2, 4, 6. I have to approximately put 0.2. 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, okay. 0.8, and this side, this we can plot as a percentage, then we have 0 and 100, then I have here maybe 20, 40, 60, 80. Yeah. So, if I plot this, the parameter will be Brinkmann number, which is the ratio of mass to heat by out numbers. So, then you will have something like this. I will put the parameter later. This is 4. Brinkmann number 4, this is 10, this is 20, okay, 100, 400, okay, 100, 400. Good. So, what do you predict from this? Nothing. There are some lines, that is all. What do you predict there? What is dt x by d overall thing? What does that tell you, that coordinate? Yeah, how much is the external heat transfer? Okay, that is why we plotted like that. Okay, yeah. So now, if the Brinkmann is 4, then we have sufficient gradients inside and also outside. That means in the film as well as in the particle. But as you move towards Brinkmann number, higher numbers 100, so at this point, for example, you have almost 70 to 80% of the temperature drop within the within the film. Okay. So, that is why most of the time these things will come to very close to this. So, all the resistance will lie only within the film. Okay. So, that is what is the message what we have to give, and generally Brinkmann number 4 is very rare. Okay. Particularly for gases, this Brinkmann numbers will be 400, 500, 600, 800 like that, okay, large numbers. So, that is the reason why we neglect the external mass transfer. Heat transfer is there definitely, heat transfer is the controlling, and inside we have mass transfer controlling. Okay. That also mass transfer control also I will tell you, but quickly we will distribute now these things. Yeah, I think I have to give Rahul come. Because there are two sets, one set I will give and one other set you give. Yeah, you give this, I will give this. Yeah, send how many? Back. Yeah. Extra? Kavya? You give to me, you will get confused. You got this? Yeah, yeah. That graph what I have just plotted. Give it to one to him and one to. Yeah, you are taken. Yeah. Yes. Good. You see, for example, this graph. You take this A side A, okay. Anurag, what is on side A? Actually, these are the measured profiles within the particle and also in the bulk. Measured, okay, beautiful work by Butt and Koyi. Yeah, you see there, A is low Brinkmann number. So, that is why there is some temperature gradient within the film, and also there is temperature gradient within the particle. Thus, radial position is a RA, R by A, 0 means center, the other side, 1 means surface. If you want, you can write there, bulk is written there, right. So, it is beautifully demonstrated here that low Brinkmann numbers, you will have the concentration gradient, I mean temperature gradients within the pellet and also within the film. Okay, understood, appreciated? No, not appreciated, only understood. Okay. Good, the next side. Next side is Brinkmann number equal to 300. Now, what is happening inside the particle? So, that means what? Isothermal. The particle is isothermal. All the gradient is only within the film. And this is so beautiful, I think they have actually measured. Wonderful, I say. Really wonderful for chemical engineers. Okay. So, that is one information. And the other information is this, that is, next graph, this is the graph what we have, I have drawn there. See, anyway, I have explained what is that, you know, most of the time you will get the Brinkmann number 400, 500 like that, you know. Yeah, now see the table, that is very important, range of parameters. What, Shekhar, what is that you are discussing? No, tell me. A graph, is there anything wrong? Yeah, what is the logic, you tell me?
No, I was thinking about a large temperature drop in the bulk.
Film is still contributing more, but inside the particle also you have?
Inside the particle is also there, that is not a point of conclusion. I was thinking about the bulk.
You have the temperature more gradient there.
Yeah.
So, that is why most of the time it is only the film which is controlling for as far as temperature is concerned. Okay? Yeah, Prabhu, the table. What do you have in the table? Yeah. So, for what are the, you know, the parameters? Normally, this is a very good table for those people who are really want to do chemical engineering later. Okay? You see, the range of parameters are given. For example, diffusivities, how they vary in systems like gas-gas, gas-liquid, gas-solid. You see now, diffusivity coefficients. For gas-gas, it is 1 to 0.1. Centimeter square per second, they are large, okay. And meter square also you can convert that, you know, 10 to the power of minus 4 you will get there. Okay. So, then you see liquid 10 to the power of minus 5 to 10 to the power of minus 6, but porous particle you just see 10 to the power of minus 1 to 10 to the power of minus 3, increased than liquids. You know why? the porosity what we are developing, we are making the catalyst pellet and we allow the gas molecules to enter into the pores. So, that is why we cannot have very, very small pores where it can be more than liquid, right. But liquid there are no pores, it has to anyway diffuse between the molecules in the liquid. So, that is the reason why you know these numbers, and of course, thermal conductivity is given, lambda is thermal conductivity, Ke, what we used. Okay, thermal conductivity range also is given, and we have the rho Cp value, that heat capacity. Then we have Arrhenius numbers, how normally they change, epsilon, epsilon is Arrhenius number. Okay, and beta is internal beta, what we have, beta x is beta bar, because this is some other book, there is a book called Lee, H. H. Lee, heterogeneous chemical reactors. So, I have taken from that this graph. So, I have collected information for from various books, H. H. Lee, chemical heterogeneous reactor design. Okay. Then Brinkmann numbers also are given, you see there for gas solid system how they vary, 10 to 10 to the power of 4. So, if you take in between value how much it will be, 10,000, no, 10 to 10,000. So, for many systems it may be in thousands. So, that is why that line will be almost on the y axis covering 100% delta T x only in the film. So, I feel this is very beautiful information, other things of course dimensionless groups and all that is given. Okay. Okay. So, the other one I think maybe tomorrow I will try to prove that you know for mass transfer always this is the internal but not external mass transfer controlling, that I think I will do it. Okay, now run. And Lewontz-Pihl gave many problems in different notations, but the same thing what we have discussed in catalytic 2-3 chapters. Okay, 2-3 chapters. So, for examination you have to really thoroughly go through that. Tomorrow what I do is I just try to prove that always it is internal effectiveness factor, internal mass transfer which is controlling internal, external mass transfer does not play a role at all, because you will have easily molecules diffusing through the film. So, that we will prove, and afterwards I will just tell you the laboratory reactors which they use for finding out observed rates. Okay. So, with that catalysis will be over, and then we will go to packet bed, fluidized bed, slurry reactor if there is time. And you have to prepare well for the exam, because exam will not be easy, because you have not so much information. It is not that only module 1, module 2 like that, from the beginning again till now.